You're dead. Right now. I've killed you. You were half asleep.
You know, I think one of the things I really like about Hanna is that she really takes advantage of the fact that people underestimate her, which, yeah, you know, ends up working out not so well for a lot of people. What was a moment in your career that you thought people might have underestimated you?
I never felt that way, really. Mm. I think, well, I mean, I started off in film when I was quite young, and I'm still young to be in film. So I started when I was around 11, and I guess people don't know what you're capable of and how far you can push yourself. But I would never say anyone has underestimated me.
Do you still feel like you need to prove yourself to people?
The people that I work with, I like them to think of me as a good actor, mm-hmm, and someone that they don't need to limit their direction or whatever they want to do with the film, because I'm not able to act for them. So I guess in that way, yeah, I like to be able to prove myself.
Mm-hmm. I mean, because at this point, you've got Atonement, and then you've got Lovely Bones, and you've got Hanna. I mean, like, you have the performances that you need to kind of prove to that you deserve to be here.
Yeah, yeah. I guess so. I mean, I think actors are always going to want to improve anyway. I know I do, and you're constantly going to want to prove yourself. But I've had great characters to play, and I've worked with really great people and people who have gotten good performances out of me, I guess.
I'll do better next time.
Tell me again.
Adept or die.
Think on your feet.
Even while I'm sleeping. I'm ready.
All you have to do is flip that switch. It tells Mercer Regler where we are.
Only you can get close enough.
She won't stop until you're dead. Or she is.
Come and find me.
I love that the idea of this movie is adapt or die. When you say that a lot, I think that's such a cool line. What is something in this business that you felt you had to adapt to in order to survive in it?
Oh, I think all of it, you know, all of it. You know, but I think it's always changing too. The business changes every sort of 3 to 6 months, I think. So I think as actors, you're always adapting to different, you know, sets, directors, films. So I think it's just part of our job, really. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I love you had some incredible hand-to-hand combat going back and forth with everybody. And I was just wondering, what kind of confidence does that instill in you? If you walk into this hotel and a guy wants to come up and pick a fight with you, do you feel like you could genuinely kick his ass?
Yeah, no, I run.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, I incorporate the sprinting component in my character. I'd like to think that it all goes into some kind of physical memory bank. It does sometimes when you go to do another film, a lot of it sort of comes back, but day to day, no, unfortunately, I think it all sort of just disappears.
Well, I think you do it well enough so that none of us would ever actually try.
That's the idea. That's the idea, ideally. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Marissa, we picked up an unencrypted signal below the Arctic Circle. We think it's Eric Heller.
Heller is a rogue asset. I propose we go in and pull him out. We need to keep this contained, gentlemen.
Papa.
Remember what I taught you, you'll be fine.
Heller was gone, but we found this kid.
I want to speak to Marissa Wiegler.
My name is Marissa Wiegler. You wanted to speak to me? It's okay.
And one of the kind of the sad things I felt bad for Hanna was that she misses out on a lot of things because of how protected she is in a way. You're saying that, you know, you've been in this business a long time. Do you think that there are things that you've missed out on because of having this career? Like, do you miss any kind of normal things, or do you still have that?
I still have that, I think, yeah. I mean, of course, I'm not at home all the time. So people carry on with their lives, just like I carry on with my life when I'm away. And there's always going to be things that you're missing out on. But I guess you just have to live with it, really.
What are some things that you do to try to, like, remain normal and try to, you know, remember that at the end of the day that you're still young? Are there things that you still like doing outside of all of this?
When I'm at home, I just hang out with my friends, and I love to listen to music and watch films and read books and just do, you know, just normal things like that. Bit of shopping is okay. I get a bit stressed out every now and again, though. Sometimes I feel a bit old, because when I'm walking around a shopping mall or something, my back will start to hurt after a while. So I feel like a little old lady, and I have to sit down on the floor while everyone's walking by, having a great time.
need you. You do things my agency will not let me do. The girl is still alive.
If we're going to be friends, you're going to have to be honest. I'd like to have a friend.
What is it?
It's something about me. I don't understand the rest of it.
What's wrong with you?
Whatever you do, promise not to follow me.
I promise.
But, you know, I was just thinking that as a parent, and I don't have any kids, so I'm not entirely sure I understand, but the idea of kind of relinquishing responsibility from your child has probably got to be the most terrifying thing. As a father, how do you not think about your kids whenever you're doing scenes like that?
I think when the material's well written, you never really have to go there. I think in this case, you know, it was very, very much about my relationship with Saoirse and with Hannah, and that becomes a focus very, very quickly. And you know, to me, the story was as much about, you know, the loss of innocence for all of us, you know, and I think it happens at different ages, for kids, for adults, and this whole sort of twisted fairy tale component, you know, makes it really interesting.
And obviously you do such a, you know, a great job of protecting her while you're with her, but then to some degree, that's an advantage and a disadvantage for her. At what point do you think protection as a father becomes a bad thing?
I have no idea. I have no idea. I think it's something I'll probably forever be trying to work out. But, you know, it's interesting when you do a film like this, there is a lot of kind of protective instinct that kicks in just for your co-star, you know, particularly for Saoirse, because, you know, she's the lead character and you got to make sure you don't punch her whilst you're doing some of these scenes. And but like I said before, you know, we had a lot of trust in each other.
Try to prepare you.
You didn't prepare me for this.
Sometimes children are bad people too.
Did she turn out as you hoped?